Hello, my dear children. Welcome back to our class. How are you all? Are you safe at your home? Okay, very good. Then let's start today's class. Are you ready? Okay, very good. Today we are going to learn a new unit, Moments of Humor. I think when you heard the topic of the unit, you are very curious to know about the moments of humor. Am I right? Okay, my dears, take your text, page number 177. Look at this cartoon. Can you guess about the characters in this cartoon? Yes, very good. The teacher and the student. The student's name is Arun. Okay, here the boy Arun is very late to school. So class teacher asking questions to him about being late. Let's see what was his reply. Look here, teacher asking Arun, why are you late, Arun? Then what was the reply of Arun? Yes, very good, because of a sign down the road. Then the teacher asking another question, what does a sign have to do with your being late? Then the reply of Arun was, the sign said, school ahead, go slow. Do you think that message is for students? No, it is not for students. It is only for the vehicles passing near the school. Okay, my dears, have you read or seen this type of cartoons? Yes, from where? Very good, the cartoon video Tindamoon Stories, right? Okay, now you take your text, page number 178. Look here, I'll read it. Listen carefully. Kerala is home to many a great humorous poet. Let's read about one of them, Kunjan Nambiar, the great poet and the storyteller. Made literary wit and humor understandable to the common man. His art form, Ottam Thullal, reflects his sense of social responsibility. Let's read an anecdote from his life. Kunjan Nambiar was very poor. He used to eat at an Ootupura maintained by the king. Those in charge of the Ootupura used to serve stale food. One day, the king and Nambiar were walking along the main road. They came across a cow passing loose dung. Nambiar went near the cow and inquired, are you also served food from King's Ootupura? The king heard this remark. He made inquiries and gave orders to dismiss the corrupt officials. Never more was stale food served at the king's Ootupura. Okay, my dears, have you heard about Kunjan Nambiar? Yes, very good. I think you may have learnt poems in Malayalam. Kunjan Nambiar was a Malayalam poet, performer, and the inventor of the local art form Ottam Thullal. His art form Ottam Thullal reflects his sense of social responsibility. He made many literary wit and humor understandable to the common man. He is often considered as the originator of Malayalam satirical poetry. Dear children, listen to me. Kunjan Nambiar was very poor. He used to eat food at an Ootupura. Have you heard about Ootupura? Yes, very good. Ootupura is an eating place maintained by king. Here food is served as free. The king appointed servants there. Nowadays we can see Ootupuras in temples. But every day there they were served the stale food. Stale food means no longer fresh or not good to eat. But no one was ready to inform this to the king. One day the king and Nambiar were walking along the road. Then they saw a cow passing loose dung. By seeing this, Nambiar went to the cow and asked, "Are you also served food from the king's utubra?" The king heard this remark. He made inquiries and gave orders to dismiss the corrupt persons. Dear children, look how beautifully he informed the evil practices at the utubra to the king. Here he used his innate sense of humor to solve a crisis. So, humor is of vital importance for human beings to survive. Children, do you want to know more about the quality of humor? Now let's read something about humor. What is humor? Humor can be simply defined as a quality in something that makes it funny. Humor leads to laughter. When laughter is shared, it brings people together and increases happiness and intimacy among them. It is interesting to note that people of all ages and cultures can respond to humor instantly. Most people are able to laugh or smile at something funny and are therefore considered to have a sense of humor. Humor and laughter, it is said, strengthen one's immune system, enhance one's energy, and protect one from the damaging effects of stress. In fact, humor is a priceless medicine. This medicine is free, quite easy to use, and available everywhere. When we crack a joke, it must be remembered that it should not hurt the feelings of anyone. Listen to me, my dears. How humor is described here? Humor is a quality in something that makes it funny. It makes laughter. Laughter brings people together, increases happiness and intimacy among them. People of all ages can respond to humor. Humor and laughter can strengthen one's immune system and protect them from the damaging effect of stress. It is a priceless medicine. It is quite easy to use and available everywhere. But remember one thing, when we crack a joke, it should not hurt the feelings of others or anyone. Okay, my dears, shall we move on to the main story part? Okay, listen to me. My Financial Career, written by Stephen Butler Leacock. Now, let's learn more about the author. Stephen Butler Leacock is an English-born Canadian teacher, writer, and humorist. He is known for his light humor and criticism of people's follies. His notable works are Sunshine Sketches of a Little Town, Arcadian Adventures with the Idle Rich, etc. The Stephen Leacock Memorial Medal for Humor was instituted in his honor. Listen to me, my dears. Stephen Butler Leacock is an English-born Canadian teacher and writer, humorist also. Then his notable works are Sunshine Sketches of a Little Town, Arcadian Adventures with the Idle Rich, etc. The Stephen Leacock Memorial Medal for Humor was instituted in his honor. Okay, let's start the lesson, My Financial Career. I'll read the lesson. You listen carefully and read with me. When I go into a bank, I get nervous. The clerks make me nervous. The little windows at the counters make me nervous. The sight of the money makes me nervous. Everything makes me nervous. Nevertheless, I had to go to the bank. There was a fair increase in my salary. I wanted to deposit the money with the bank. I felt that the bank was the only place for it. Okay, my dears, listen to me. I'll give the detailed explanation. In this humorous story, the author very interestingly narrates a series of humorous instances he faced in a bank. When the owner went to the bank first, he became nervous. Nervous means anxious about or afraid of something. He was afraid of the clerks, the little windows at the counter, the sight of money, and he afraid of everything there in the bank, even though he had to go to the bank because there was a fair increment in his salary. He wanted to deposit it in a bank because he thought that the bank was the only safe place for it. Okay, my dears, I will read the next two paragraphs. Listen to me. I walked in with dragging feet and looked shyly round at the clerks. I had an idea that a person about to open an account must consult a manager. I went up to the counter marked accountant. The accountant was a tall, cool fellow. The very sight of him made me nervous. My voice was deep and hollow. Listen, here the owner thought that the only safe place to deposit his increment salary was the bank. So he walked very shyly and looked at the clerks in the bank. He thought that when a person wants to open an account, he must consult a manager. So he went to the counter marked as accountant. The accountant was tall and cool fellow. When he saw him, he became nervous. So his voice was deep and hollow. By his fear, he couldn't ask anything very boldly to him. Okay, my dears, listen to the rest of the story. I'll read it. Can I see the manager? I said and added solemnly, alone. I don't know why I said alone. Certainly, said the accountant. The manager was a grave, calm man. Are you the manager? I asked. Yes, he said. Can I see you? I asked alone. I didn't want to say alone again, but I couldn't help it. The manager looked at me in some alarm. He felt that I had a terrible secret to reveal. Okay, my dears, listen to me. After some time, the owner asked to him, can he see the manager alone? But he couldn't understand why did he say alone. Then the man replied, certainly. The manager was very serious, calm person. Then he asked him, are you the manager? Then he replied that, yes. Then the owner told to the manager that he want to see him alone. Then the manager looked at him alarm. Alarm means fear of an anxious awareness of danger. He looked at me very anxiously with fear of danger. He felt that he had to reveal a terrible secret to him. Okay, my dears, did you enjoy the story? Hope you understood today's portion. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.